Yeah. Let's give this a try. Whoa.
Never been up here before. I have heard of the sages of Mithravar, but never gave them much thought.
Why not?
Isn't a story worthless if it isn't shared? If the accounts of our past are kept hidden, they may as well not exist at all.
Looks like we need to find another way.
I wonder if the sages up here know anything about the Remnant. It's probably too much to hope they'll share secrets with us.
I wouldn't count on it. Look at that.
Thank you. is that possible? An alien?
I am Ryder, Pathfinder with the Andromeda Initiative, from the Milky Way galaxy.
That does not explain how or why you are able to operate the remnant doors. It doesn't matter. You must leave. We do not entertain guests here.
Havarl's in decline. If you tell me about the lost monolith, I can help fix it. Reset the vault.
With Ryder's help, Havarl could be healed. Our birthplace restored. Isn't that worth something?
It's lost. The memories of its location haven't been reclaimed. On Mithrava, we have accepted Havarl's eventual ruin.
You're just giving up on your planet? Isn't this your birthplace? Don't you want to save it?
A chasm separates want from can. What you ask, no one can give. The memory of the monolith resides within a thread that slipped from our grasp.
I'm not sure I follow.
We believe in reincarnation. An unbroken thread.
There was one, long ago, who had knowledge of the third monolith. Zorai, a champion of the Angara from before the Scourge. Zorai's soul has returned and could be made to remember what it knew. But we have no contact with it.
So you're saying there's some way we can make people remember their past lives?
Souls retain within families. An object, heirloom, tied closely to that bloodline could cause memories to resurface.
But it's not guaranteed.
It has been known to happen on rare occasions in the past, with other souls. The only known heirloom of Zorai's family rests in an area with active remnant. No one has survived the journey. But perhaps you. Zorai's soul was reborn in Tavos, who is now a Roka. He recently returned to Havarl on a mission.
A Roka? That'll be difficult.
That's why you're here, Jahl.
They won't like that I'm helping you.
This may be a dead end, but we have to try.
I will send you the relevant coordinates. We considered Havarl a lost cause. But perhaps now, there is hope. You have questions?
Why do you remain secluded here?
The chaos brought on by the Scourge splintered our people and all but destroyed our civilization. Fear took hold. False beliefs about our predicament were seeded and began to influence Angaran thought. In order to maintain the integrity of what they knew to be true, four families left their community to come here. We've remained ever since.
Tell me more about your belief in reincarnation.
The soul grows through many lifetimes. By seeing through different eyes, it gains wisdom.
How do you grow if you don't remember?
The growth of the soul is not like the growth of the mind. Memories are not required for the soul to develop. Some even argue that old memories are an unwelcome distraction. A person may become fixated on what was, and their soul consequently stagnates.
You mentioned an heirloom, an object you think will bring Zorai's memories back?
Souls return within families. Sometimes the memories of the past can be recalled by an object meaningful to that family. We do not understand why or how this happens, and it has only happened on rare occasions. In all cases, the heirloom was ancient. Old Angara tech from before the Scourge.
Tell me more about Zorai.
The histories describe him as both scholar and soldier. He traveled the stars and gained knowledge from far-off places. There are even accounts of him having knowledge of the remnant builders and their machines.
And the third monolith?
Our legends say that Zorai sought out the monoliths after the Scourge came. He died, and it is unclear if he accomplished what he set out to do.
I'll go. Thank you for speaking to me.
Of course.
Activating automated forward station deployment.
As death nears, it's harder to face the possibility that I might never see Ahmada again.
Sorry to interrupt, but what's happened?
Ahmad is ill. He hasn't got much time left. Ahmad, perhaps this stranger can help. If they've been to Palev, maybe they've seen something.
I came from Palev, actually. The little research station.
Research station? It used to be a large settlement. A dar. Ahmada moved them when she left Mithrava.
Palav was overtaken by the jungle, remember? A few cycles ago, everyone left.
Oh, yes. I remember now. But that means Amara's gone.
There might still be a way to track her down.
All Dara keep records, don't they? If there was an organized evacuation, they would have documented the process.
And the records would state where she went. Pala, that's genius.
Where would they keep those records?
Likely some kind of administrative building. If it still stands, and the machines still work, it's a slim hope. I don't want to impose, stranger, but I would welcome any news of my sister.
Another memory trigger?
One of your father's memories is now accessible. Return to Samnode on the Hyperion to investigate further.
Thank you.
Christmas lets you wander around with no supervision? You're interrupting our lesson.
Could use more interruptions.
Sorry, I didn't mean to get in your way.
And yet you're still here. As I was saying, the propulsion system that took Bashal to the skies was inspired by four remnant pieces. And that's just one. Much of our progress was prompted by the discovery of remnant artifacts.
Where are these artifacts you're talking about?
The few that still exist reside in Aya's repository. However, many have been lost. Though there are rumors that as wilds grow wilder, things long buried may be unearthed.
It might be wise to study whatever we find. Something out there might give us an edge against the Ket.
You believe the Angara learned crucial scientific ideas from the Remnant?
It is not just belief, it is a matter of record. Some artifacts were even left in unfinished states, likely to demonstrate how they were put together.
I think I'll leave you to your lesson.
About time.
Ah, good. I wanted to talk with you.
How are you able to use the Remnant?
With an artificial intelligence that helps with analysis and translation.
So that's the trick. I wouldn't have guessed. Angara, who live close to Remnant technology, sometimes learn how to use specific tech. It requires intense concentration, and even if we can make it work, we've never understood how it works.
So some of you can use Remnant tech, but you don't know how it works?
Not all Remnant tech, no. Like I said, specific pieces. Take Mithrava, for example. Some of us can operate the security that protects the Sanctuary. The knowledge was passed down through generations. In my case, it took a year to learn how to open a simple door. The difference between knowing you can eat a tree's fruit and understanding why that tree bears fruit.
I should be going.
Suit yourself.
Pathfinder, we are approaching the location provided by Esmus.
Stay sharp, everybody. There's supposed to be a remnant crawling all over this place. Shaw, what's your take on all this reincarnation stuff?
You're asking if I believe?
Yes, sure.
Not the way Esmus does.
Got it. Looks like it might have been some kind of glove or gauntlet. Smashed, though. Inside studded with contacts. Could have been used for some kind of input.
I wish we could study it instead of giving it to this Tavos person.